today I'd like us to look at the millennium rule of Christ, the end of time and the end of sin. Hallelujah. But before we do that, I'd like somebody to just help us remember according to the biblical prophetic timelines. So mi nasema kitu moja, na wewe unasema nini inafaa kuja next. Mnanielewa eh? Mnanielewa kweli? So mi naweza sema like great deception. So what is coming next? Falling away, after the falling away, what is coming next? After the rapture? And the revealing of the Antichrist. And then tunaingia kwa the? Yeah? 3.5 years of peace, The second coming of Jesus. What event will Jesus find happening? Kutakuwa na war. Inaitwaje? Armageddon. Ambia jirani yako kumbe umekuwa ukishika haki. Si kwa naona kama unashika. Hebu mwambie congratulations, you are really catching. Ala. So you've been catching. Aya, wacha tuone tena. After the rapture, kutakuwa na the signing of the peace treaty, si ndio? After the signing of the peace treaty, the tribulation will begin. What? So kutakuwa na 3.5 years of peace, eh? And then the last 3.5 years zitakuwa the tribulation, si ni kweli? Hiyo zote ni how many years the total? 7. Okay? So after the 7, Jesus is coming back. So the rapture is here. How many years from the rapture to Jesus coming back? 7. Until the peace treaty. Thank you. Hey, Grace Leo, kwani Mrs. Ochieng, you are very powerful. Mrs. Ochieng after points. So you cannot count after the rapture. You wait for the signing. Because the signing is what is in the prophecy of Daniel. Daniel alianzia could count the last week, which is 7 years, when the signing is done. So is there a way? I told you there is a way we can predict the time between the rapture and the signing. But that one, I did not share sneakily. But you can predict, and I told you, you can do that using the Jewish feasts. But I did not teach about the feasts. So why don't you tell me something about the feasts, then I teach about the millennium. Is that okay? So the Jews had 7 major feasts. Ya kwanza ilikuwa inaitwa Passover. Passover. Write it down. Ya pili ilikuwa inaitwa the Feast of Unleavened Bread. Ya tatu ilikuwa inaitwa the Feast ya the Fast Fruit. Ya nne ilikuwa inaitwa the Feast of Pentecost ama the Feast of Weeks. Ya tano ilikuwa inaitwa the Feast of Trumpets. Ya sita ilikuwa inaitwa the Feast of Atonement. Na ya saba ilikuwa inaitwa the Feast of the Tabernacle. Are we together? So Jesus dealing with the church, ndio church ianze na ndio aikujie, alifuata pattern ya the feasts. So ile siku enye kwa calendar ni Passover is the same day he died, because he is now the Passover lamb. So kama ulikuwa unajua the feasts, you could predict to the day when Jesus will die. Hiyo siku akicelebrate Passover ndiye aliuliwa. So somebody that was studying the feasts could tell people, I know when they will kill him. It is tomorrow when we are celebrating Passover. All right? So now that you can already predict the movements of Jesus using the feasts of the Jews. Alibaki kwa the grave on the day of the unleavened bread. Alisema, I am the bread of life. He was being cooked. You understand what I'm saying? And then he resurrected day at the feast of the first fruit. Na Bible inasema he is the first fruit. He is the first fruit. also pia anaitwa the firstborn. So angalia, Yesu anafuata the feasts because all these things Bible inasema were pointing to him. Si aliambia the Pharisees, you search the scriptures for you think in them is eternal life, Matthew 5:39, but these scriptures point to me, so you can find Jesus in the feast. Then akawaambia, I will not leave you helpless, I will not leave you alone, I will send another one like me, Allos Paracletos, the Holy Spirit. Guess which day the Holy Spirit came? The day when people were celebrating Pentecost. That day is the day the Holy Spirit came. Do you understand what I'm saying? It was going to happen 49 days after the resurrection, the first fruit. Total 50. Pentecost inamaanisha 50. Are we together? So sasa tunajiuliza, na Yesu atakuja lini? We can still check the feasts that he did not touch in his movements. Unaona? So which is the next feast after the Pentecost? So Paul anasema, at the last trump. You are missing what I'm saying. Yesu alisema, at the last trump, that is Paul. When the last trump sounds, tutakuwa caught up. So Paul alisema, the rapture will happen at the last trump. On the day of the trumpet, the feast of trumpet, they were blowing 100 trumpets. Ya mwisho ilikuwa inaitwa the last trump. Walikuwa naita hivyo. So when Paul alisema the last trump, the Jews understood, because understand, Paul had a Jewish background. So vile alisema the last trump, Jews knew that we use this word, last trump, every feast of trumpets. Ile ya mwisho huwa tunaita hivyo. Are we together? Are you understanding what I'm saying? Are you understanding what I'm saying? So, I can take a whole hour to tell you why Jesus atakuja on the Feast of Trumpets. There is so much evidence that we don't have time for. Hallelujah. 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 As people were waiting for the Feast of Trumpets, do you know what was happening? A whole month before, every day, a trumpet was being blown. Watu walikuwa naambiwa, prepare your hearts. That is what we are doing now. That whole time, between, prepare your hearts. Prepare your hearts. Prepare your hearts. Prepare your hearts. And then, the day of the feast of the trumpet in Akuja, and they used to celebrate that feast 2 days. The reason being, they didn't know when they will see the moon. Kwa sababu walikuwa nafaa kuangalia moon. So walikuwa naambiwa, of that day, no one knows the day or the hour ya kufanya the feast of the trumpet. So watachagua, wakiona wanafanya 2 days, so that was wakue accurate. Unajua like, siju kama ushaiona Waislamu wakiangalia moon. Unapata Mombasa wako na siku yao, Kisumu wako na their own day. So they used to do it for 2 days. The same thing Yesu alisema, of that day, no man knows the day or the hour. Hiyo phrase haikuwa original na Yesu. That is what they used to say about the Feast of Trumpets. Nobody knows the day. And I can continue saying reasons why. After the Feast of Trumpets, they used to mark 10 days. After 10 days, wanakuwa na the Feast of Atonement. That is the day when the high priest, it is the most holy day in the calendar of the Jews. Inaitwa Yom Kippur. Ushaisikia hiyo? It's the Feast of Atonement. On that day, the priest, high priest, anachukua 2 goats. Anaenda na meet God face to face. Hiyo ndio ile ulikuwa unasikia, he can die inside. So wanamfunga nini? Kamba. It is the day when he finally goes to meet God. It is the day when the world will finally see Jesus. The day of atonement. It is the day of, that's like your judgment imefika. Atonement. You understand what I'm saying? Ilikuwa ina happen how many days? 10 days. So I'm saying, from the Feast of the Trumpets, from the rapture, you can count 10 years. That is when Jesus will come. So in Amanisha, the signing will probably happen around 3 years after the rapture. So after 20, people will still have like 3 years when there is chaos. People are fighting each other, so that now the Antichrist signs what? Peace. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Are we together? Shake your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, it is still a message for you. It is still a message for you. So nasema hii message kwa zinaenda YouTube. Na watu wenye wataachwa watawatch. So wataweza kujua. Na maana ule pastor alikuwa wa ukweli. Wataka calculate. Hallelujah. And then Jesus will come back. Pastor Brenda alikuwa na dream ya rapture. Umemwambia hiyo dream? Ah. Pastor Brenda aliona akikuwa raptured. Jana asubuhi. Nikamuuliza mimi nilikuwa wapi? Akaniambia sikukuona. Sema, what is happening? Sasa nashinda nikijiuliza nilikuwa wapi? Maybe nilikuwa nishaenda, eh? Yeah. Amen. I receive. So ningependa Pastor Brenda ashare na sisi your dream for like 3-2 minutes, just because of something in the dream that is important. Fantastic. Let us clap for her as she comes.
Amen. So praise God.
Amen.
Praise God again.
Amen.
Tell somebody next to you, tunaenda mbinguni. We are going. The marriage supper is waiting for us. Amen. So it was actually yesterday after the travel, yoko kupumzika. So I'm not sure which detail he wants me to capture, but I will try and remember everything. So I was near pipeline. That's what I remember. I was near that area, Southfield.
I was there too, in the name of Jesus.
Amen. So I was near that area, and we were caught up. Like I saw, you know, the way we'll catch up with him in the air. So I saw him. And then my body started transforming. Najua mwili mpya. It started happening. So I felt it in my hands. I could feel it in my hands and part of my head. So when I caught the dream, I was in between. Ni kama sasa the transformation is happening. Like now I'm going. But I caught it in between. So I could tell, navutwa, iki tunaenda. So I saw him and then I was caught up with him. And
him,
then,
him is Jesus.
Jesus, yes.
I connect, I receive.
So I was caught up with him, so I saw him, and then now that was happening in the middle. And at the same time, somehow, now after it had already happened, oh, there's something else. The way I knew it's rapture, I don't know how to explain it. You know, sometimes the way the dream world is, I had a tingling voice. I can't explain it. It was like inalia kama ile nini ya hospital ile ti. So it's need. And then that's when now my body started, the things started happening. And after that, somehow I could see the tribulation at the same time, really. It's like maybe years later, but I saw people wanna, because of the fear and everything that was going on. So I saw people living many together. Ile venye, if there was terror, watu wanaenda wanakaa pahali pamoja. So that's what I saw, many families wanakaa mahali pamoja. I hope I have captured everything.
Fantastic. Iko sawa. Let us appreciate Jesus. Wow. So umeona? So as tuna, we will know that we are going. Utasikia something deep. Then your body will change. You will receive a new body. Then uende mbinguni. A celestial body. Kama ile yenye Yesu aliresurrect nayo. You remember Jesus could walk through walls after he resurrected, but he could still eat fish. So you'll have that body. It can do terrestrial jobs, but it is a celestial body. Are we together? And then unasikia alisema alisikia akichange. So it means we will feel ourselves changing. And then akaona in the world, because of the fear and the confusion, many people will begin to live together. Yeah. So you will find like families preferring to be squeezed together because of fear. That is very deep. I think it is already very deep. So I'd like us to see something in a few minutes. Are you blessed to be here? Are you blessed to be here? Tell your neighbor, we must go together. Oh yes. I'd like us to look at the millennium rule of Christ. Millennium inamaanisha 1,000 years. Millennium inamaanisha 1,000 years. Mile ama mili is 1,000. Alafu anam years. So millennium 1,000 years. Hallelujah. Revelation chapter 20 verse 1. I want you to see something. Revelation 20 verse 1. So after 20 na Yesu in the rapture, after 7 years of tribulation, we will come back. Sini sawa? We will come back. We will come back with him. To do what? To rule the world. Na hapo ndo tuliona, the beast and his prophet will be cast into the lake of fire. Situliona hiyo? Situliona hiyo? Then immediately, what will happen? The millennium rule of Christ will begin. Revelation 20 verse 1, then I saw an angel coming down from heaven, having the key of the bottomless pit and a great chain in his hand. Continue. And he laid hold of the dragon, that serpent of old, who is the devil and Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. So after the tribulation, Satan will be taken and he will be put in prison for 1,000 years. Continue. And he cast him into the bottomless pit and shut him up and set a seal on him so that he should not deceive the nations no more till the 1,000 years were finished. Are we together? Are we together? Are we together? But after these things, he must be released for a little while. Shetani atachiliwa tena. Are we together? Continue. And I saw thrones, and they sat on them, and judgment was committed to them. Then I saw the souls of those who had been beheaded for their witness to Jesus and for the word of God, who had not worshipped the beast or his image, and have not received his mark on their foreheads or on their hands. And they lived on and reigned with Christ for 1,000. So we shall live and reign with Christ for 1,000 years here on earth. One thing unafaa kuwa umeshaanza kuona tukilani series, we will not stay in heaven for a long time. Heaven is only 7 years and we are done. 10 years and we come back. There is nothing much we are doing in heaven. And we shall never go back. Huko utakuwa unaenda ukijisikia tu kwa sababu ni kwa baba yako. Lakini ni kama vile unaenda ushago. Nani unarudi home. We shall never go back there to stay there. Tutaishi in the, unaona hii dunia hii? 1,000 years. This one. For 1,000 years. Aya. Na Biblia inasema we shall reign with Christ. Yesu ataenda Israel, Jerusalem, and atakuwa na a big temple there. A very glorious temple in the millennium. And he will sit there. And people will be coming from all over the world once in a while to go and worship him physically. Are we together? Are we together? Sisi tutakuwa na glorified bodies. Sio hizi mwili. But kutakuwa na watu wa Mungu wenye hawatakuwa na glorified bodies. Who are those people? They are the ones who survived the tribulation. They received Jesus. Remember, they were never raptured. So our watabaki na mortal bodies. So we shall have wale wenye mtabaki huku time ya tribulation. Kwa sababu umesema siwezi acha kusikiza secular, kwani siwezi nikajienjoy. Sasa wewe kaka hapa. Wewe utakuwa na mortal bodies. Kwani wewe ni sawa tu wewe kunywa. Mortal mortal bodies. But sisi tutakuwa na immortal bodies. So we are the ones that will reign with him. And we shall reign over the people with mortal bodies. They will be the ones working tukitaka kujenga barabara, wewe si umesema kwani zoezi sikiza secular, ni sawa, sikiza secular. Tukitaka kujenga barabara kwa millennium, ni wewe tunawa, we lord over you. Are we together? I'm telling you. Are we together? So I want to share a few things about the millennium. Will you give me time? Will you give me your attention? All right. Micah chapter 4 verse 1 inasema, now it shall come to pass in the latter days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established on top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and people shall flow to it. Continue. Many nations shall come and say, come and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his ways and we shall walk in his paths. I know, you see, there are so many scriptures in the Bible that we confess today, but when you read them with understanding, they are not for today. Yeah. Akuna mahali, all nations will come and say to somebody anaitwa he. You see, it's not talking about pastors. He. Who is he? It means Jesus will be somewhere and people will be coming to him. Give us the wisdom to rule our nations. Do you understand what I'm saying? Are we together? Are we together? Are we together? Another fact about the millennium, Jesus will reign with David. Jeremiah 30 verse 9. The King David, the one and only King David that you know. Huyo ni kama ni atakuwa nini, prime minister. Yeah. Bible inasema, but they shall serve the Lord their God and David their king, whom I will raise up for them. Jeremiah 30 verse 9. Ezekiel 37 verse 24. David became very close to God. And when it comes to kingship, Mungu ameentrust David. Yeah, amependa David sana. Hadi alimwambia, wewe the throne haitawahi depart from you. But they shall serve, where? Ezekiel 37, 24. David my servant shall be king over them. Hapa anaongea kama David amesha kufa. But anasema, David shall be king over them. And they shall have one shepherd. They shall also walk in my judgment and observe my statutes and do them. So David will be. So tukienda huko, utakuwa unapata ule mkubwa huko. Apart from Yesu, David ako hapo. Yeah. Another fact about the millennium will be full of peace. Nations hazitakuwa zina fight. Micah chapter 4 verse 2 and 3. Micah 4, 2 and 3. And Isaiah 11, 6 to 8. Yeah, maybe to some Isaiah, yeah, Micah, you can read it alone. Isaiah 11, verse 6. Look at this. There'll be so much peace during those 1,000 years. Yeah. I want you to see the kind of peace that will be there. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb. Fisi itaka, si fisi nani? Wolf nani? Mweha. Mweha na kondoo wataka pamoja. Nothing is fighting nothing. Nations are not fighting nations. Animals are not fighting animals. The leopard shall lie down with the young goat. Mliona ile simba ilitokea huko Rongai? Ukiona itakuwa inakuja ipeleke umbwa out, wanarudi. Yeah. Hakutakuwa na mnatafuta tu kwa CCTV wameenda wapi kwa out. Na wanarudi. Yeah. The calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. Mtoto mdogo ni atakuwa anaongoza lion, leopard anaziambia twende hivi tukacheze. During the millennium. Si uokoke. Sasa mbona unasumbuka kuokoka? Unataka kumisi. Continue. Look at this. Verse 7. The cow and the bear shall graze together. Their young ones shall lie down together. And the lion shall eat the straw like the ox. Kwa millennium, lion hazikuli nyama. Zinakula nyasi. Yeah. Kwa sababu hazifai kufight. Ni peace. I'm telling you. Nilikuwa nafikiria ile kitu tunaweza achiwa tukule ni samaki. Samaki inaonanga kama zina friends. Nilikuwa concerned. Sasa millennium atakula nyama. Unajua mtoto hawezi cheza na ng'ombe, tena uwe hiyo ng'ombe. Si ni kweli? Yeah. So ama unakimbisha kuku, dogi na kuangalia tu like seriously. Because friends. But nika feel ni negotiate na Mungu. What about fish? Fish iko tu peke yake. Hallelujah. Continue. The nursing child shall play by the cobra's hole. ule mtoto mdogo mwenye ananyonya unamwacha tu kwa shimo ya kobra na unampata hapo akicheza. In the millennium there is no war, there is no fight, and the wind child shall put his hand in the viper's den. Mtoto ule mwenye ameanza kukula anaweka mkono kwa shimo ya viper na anaichukua na anacheza nayo. They never get born again. There is so much to see. There is so much to see. Hallelujah. So there will be peace. People are not fighting. Animals are not fighting. Next, there shall be prolonged life. Look at this. Isaiah 65 verse 20. Isaiah 65 verse 20. Prolonged life. Isaiah 65 verse 20. Are you loving this? Are you happy that you are born again? Ajua ukiimba ninafurahi nimeokoka. Oka. Hiyo wimbo ukiona hizi vitu unasikia kuimba tena. Because kuokoka is such a nice thing. No more shall an infant, Isaiah 65 verse 20, no more shall an infant from their lives, no more shall an infant from there live but a few days. Mtoto hataishi miaka kidogo. Nor an old man who has not fulfilled his days. For the child shall die akiwa 100 years old. Ukiwa na miaka 100 ukufe, wanasema mtoto amekufa. Yeah. Because people will be living very long. I know we use this scripture to pray, but this does not make sense now. Sinu kweli? Hata mtu akiwa na miaka 100, tunasema ako na long life, but we don't say he's a child. This is for the millennium. Ukikufa na miaka 100, you are a child. For the child shall die 100 years old. But the sinner, being 100, shall be accursed. So I want to tell you, it is not your children. These are not your children. These are not your children. Remember, I have told you, there are people who will survive tribulation na watakubali Yesu na watakuwa kwa millennium. Hao wakipata watoto, watoto wao hawatakuwa wameokoka. Because God does not have grandchildren. God has what? Children. So salvation is not transferred from mother to child. So wale watoto watazaliwa kwa tribulation. Are you here?
Yes.
Are you here?
Yes.
Some of them will become sinners. Kwa tribulation, I mean kwa millennium, wale watoto watazaliwa kwa millennium, some of them watakuwa sinners. And this is to help us understand, eh? Usiseme unatenda dhambi juu una pesa. Ati ya maisha ni ngumu, lazima mtu ajipange. Hapana, wewe hata ukipewa pesa utatenda dhambi. Because there will be no lack here. There will be peace. Everything will be perfect, but people will still rebel against God. Are we together? Are you really hearing what I'm saying? So people that sin in the millennium, because Jesus atakuwa around, he will be judging them immediately. They die. Ukiishi na dhambi anakumaliza. So the sinner shall be accursed. So there are people that will die because of judgment. By Yesu atakuwa Jerusalem. Pakiwa na dhambi, anajudge immediately. Yeah. Those that don't sin, ju hawana mortal bodies, immortal bodies. Do you remember what I said? Sisi ndio tutakuwa na immortal bodies. Their bodies will be mortal. Even if they don't sin, they live for a long time, but they die early. They still die. Si mnakumbuka after sin itoke hivi, before the effects of sin zikuwe mingi, people used to live for 900 years. Methuselah 960 something. Yeah. They used to live for 900 years, 700 years. That is what will happen here. Even if they don't have immortal bodies, their mortal bodies will live long, because of the absence of sin. Are we together? But they will still do what? Die. Yeah. But sisi, because we will have immortal bodies, we will not die. Are we together? Are we together? Are you sure you are learning something? Is this helping you? Ama should I say receive your husband, receive your wife? Mtu amesema both, pastor, both, both, both. Mix the message. Hallelujah. Amen. So kutakuwa na long life. let me tell you, death is a consequence of sin. Even if you are not a sinner, the fact that there is sin in this world, vile sin ilikuja, people began to die. Wakaanza na 900, ikaenda 300s, time ya kina Abraham ilikuwa 100s, Abraham alika 175, ikashuka to 120, ikashuka to 80 in scripture. So saizi wanasema ukipita 80, you are blessed. Because of the increase of sin. But that time, because sin will not be there, people will begin to live long. Hallelujah. But that is not for you. Simenielewa. If you are born again, you shall have immortal bodies. You shall be ruling with Christ. Are we together? Yeah. Am I talking to two people? There shall be so much joy. So much joy. Isaiah 14, verse 7. The whole earth is at rest and quiet. They break forth into singing. Isaiah 14, verse 7. Rest and quiet. Watu tu wanakaa wanaimba. Unaamka tu usiku unaanza kuimba. Yeah. Unazubaki kidogo unaanza kuimba because of the peace and the rest and the joy. Do you understand what I'm saying? There shall be righteousness. People will not be sinning. Isaiah 11:9. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain. For the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. Isaiah 11:9. I know we pray with this scripture, that the earth shall be full with the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. But it does not make sense now. Be sure there are places in this world that will not receive Jesus now. Yeah. Ni one people in those areas. But there are nations that will remain in sin. But at this time, the whole earth shall be covered with the, shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. People will be practicing righteousness. Are we together? Are we together? Are we together? Zechariah 13 verse 2. Zechariah 13 verse 2. It shall be in that day, says the Lord of hosts, that I will cut off the names of the idols from the land, and they shall no longer be remembered. All idols. Do you know there are idols in every nation in this world? Idols in every village in this world. So, yes, we are preaching and we are winning souls, but we cannot cut off all the idols. But anasema, at this time, he will cut off all idols. So, hakutakuwa na idol worship. Are we together? There will be so much prosperity. That is the next thing. Isaiah 8:12. For the seed shall be prosperous. The vine shall give its fruit. All these are prophecies about the millennium. Are we together? Are you learning something? Are you learning something? And we shall reign with him. Hallelujah. So, saizi there are politically elected leaders. Sinikweli? Jana juzi kulikuwa na election South Africa. Simeona hiyo? Simeona hiyo ama mjaona? In this world, leaders are what? Elected. But at that time, leaders will be appointed by Jesus. Yeah. So utapata the leaders of the leader wa Kenya amechaguliwa na Yesu. Assistant wake ni Yesu amemchagua. The cabinet, it is Jesus. That is a good place to say wow. I said that is a good place to say wow. Ukienda TZ, every parastato, every leader has been chosen by Jesus. That is a good place to say wow. I will say another country so that you say why. Ukienda USA, the leader has been chosen by Jesus. The vice president, Jesus amemchagua. Can you imagine? Because we shall reign with him over the earth. So the affairs of the earth, minister of transport, ni Yesu amechagua. Anaangalia nani walikuwa wanaenda soul winning wakitembea kwa jua wanachomeka. Minister of transport and yeah. Shake your neighbor. Tell him, serve God today. Serve God today. I'm telling you. Now, can I tell you something? Our reigning, I want to say something powerful, but I don't know if you are ready. Our reigning shall be a reward. I'm just reacting when you're going to attack. Our reigning shall be a reward. Yeah. So, we will be given positions as a reward according to how we have served God here. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you hearing what I'm saying? 1 Corinthians 6:2 inasema, let us read together. 1 Corinthians 6:2. You see, ukiambia watu please go for soul winning, they think you are doing it for them. Me, I don't have any souls that miss sitaji souls. You are doing it for him and he will pay you. Do you not know that the saints will judge the world? And if the world will be judged by you, are you unworthy to judge the smallest matters? Kwa nini mnashindwa kufanya vitu ndogo za saa hii na mnangojewa mjudge the world at that time? I'm telling you. Look at verse, do you have verse 3? Verse 3. Do you not know that you shall judge angels? How much more the things that pertain to this life? Wewe kitu kidogo na boyfriend yako, amwezi solve. Na unafaa usolve vitu za malaika. Shake your neighbor, tell him you need to upgrade. You need to upgrade wewe. No, it is you I'm talking about. You need to upgrade. We are supposed to judge angels. Unaambia malaika, I don't like the way you are running today. Don't you have wings? Wings to fly. Can you imagine? Unaambia malaika, slow your speed please. Do this, do this. So the things of this world, believe God to have wisdom to solve these small, small things. Pastor huyu ameniangalia vibaya. Sasa nifanya nini? Mimi nakuangalia vizuri. Mimi nakuangalia vizuri. Solve your shake never tell me begin to solve issues. Solve issues. Are you hearing me? Revelation 20 verse 4 ndio inasema, we shall reign with him. We shall reign with him. Are we together? Angalia Daniel 7:27. Daniel 7:27. I'm telling you why you need to serve God. Don't spend all your time working for yourself. Hiyo siku utakumbuka hii somo. Daniel 7:27. The kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdoms under the whole heaven shall be given to the people, the saints of the Most High. His kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominion shall serve and obey him. Can you imagine? The kingdom shall be given to the saints. Russia, Qatar, all these places, but we shall replace the names. We don't like those names. We shall give them other names. All those places shall be given to us. Can you imagine? Now all the positions, president, vice president, ministers, what, education, everything, is the Mungu atapatia servants wake. Can you imagine? Can you imagine what I'm saying? Okay, I don't know if you are imagining, but I'm imagining it. And it is too powerful. Revelation chapter 5, verse 9. Revelation 5, 9. You see, let me tell you something. Tulikuwa tunaongea Pastor Brenda. Do you know if the rapture happens today, then whatever we are talking about is happening in the next 7 to 10 years. It is not far. You see, we put this life like it is far. If the rapture happens today, in the next 7 to 10 years, this begins. And you shall see people that you knew being given positions. Unaambiwa make sure umempikia cha chai. Shake your neighbor, tell him to serve God. It is not far. And God will not look at your academics. Sijui ulikuwa na degree. No. It is your faithfulness to him. So even if you didn't go to university, it will not matter there. Do you know even what they teach in university is what they know? What if they are wrong? Okay, you are missing what I'm saying. Ile kitu tunafundishana huko, ni ile tunajua. Na wale wenye wameandika hiyo, hata au waliambiwa na mwingine. What if they are wrong? Degree zenyu mna... Saki kusema mbinguni hakuna degree, juu hiyo wimbo... But mbinguni hakuna? Adam na Hawa hawakuwa na? Kuna watu wamefurahia sana. I'm telling you, your faithfulness. Uliambiwa uko unacheza hiyo bass, Alex, unacheza tu bass kila Sunday. Du 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 du. Wednesday na u complain uko tuna hiyo base yako travel anacheza tu base yake. It is the faith, it is not the work. God does not does not pay you for your assignment. Set ulikuwa pastor. God will not reward positions. Set yet a reward ulikuwa pastor. This is your reward. No, it is faithfulness. Mali nilikuweka. Did you do it with all your heart? So utapata at a worship team member amefanya kitu na all their heart more than the pastor. So that worship team member will get a greater reward than the pastor. It is faithfulness in your area. I'm telling you. So uko hapa na ufanyii Mungu kitu. Revelation chapter 5, look at this. And they sang a new song saying, "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood out of every tribe and tongue and people and nation." Next verse. Look at this. "And you have made us kings." Yes, we read this scripture today. Sini kweli. But I'm telling you, we are not experiencing it in its fullness today. This scripture, we will sing this at that time. Tutaambia Yesu, "You redeemed us and you have made us kings." Tutakuwa tunatembea hii dunia kama kings. There are people that are being abused. Pastors wanatusiwa online. They are being abused every day. There's a time that is coming. They shall be walking like kings. Utapata mtu ana control Asia, ana control Africa, one person. Another person amepatiwa East Africa. Mwingine amepatiwa Kenya. Na ndio tutaanza kuimba tuseme, "You have made us kings." Yani, we were sinners, you have made us kings. You understand what I'm saying? So now we can begin to walk in authority, speak like kings. But I'm telling you, the full realization of this scripture utaiona hiyo time. Utaona watu wenye walikuwa sinners wakafuata Yesu akawaokoa, amewafanya kings. Do you understand what I'm saying? Are we together? Revelation chapter 20 verse 4, hiyo tumesoma, "We shall reign with him." Revelation chapter 2 verse 25. Revelation 2:25. "But hold fast to what you have till I come." Hiyo kazi yenye nimekupatia, hiyo guitar, shikilia. Useme najisikia na keyboard, shikilia nini? Guitar. Next verse. Look at this. "And he who overcomes." Yani, hata sasa unacheza guitar na unasikia umeboeka. Ikiwa uta overcome hiyo kuboeka. Unanielewa eh? Wewe ni Asha, unasalimia tu watu, wengine unawaambia kaa hapa, wanakaa hapa. Ukiovercome hiyo hasira, usiingize hasira. Ukae tu umefurahia ukiserve Mungu eh. "If you overcome and keep my work," ile kazi nimempatia ameishikilia, "I will give him power over," I can't hear you, "over what?"
Nations.
"Power over what?"
Nations.
"Over nations, because of holding to your work." Umeambiwa tu kuwa unaosha hapa, auoshi. Kuwa unafanya hii kwa kanisa, nilisahau. Kuwa I'm telling you, if the rapture happens today, it's only a few years. Na utakuwa like, "Why didn't I do my work seriously? Mbona sikuwa faithful?" If you hold on to his work, umeambiwa leo wewe ni backup, backup. Useme, "Ah, si ningekuwa lead." Backup. Tell your neighbor, "Back up." Do you understand what I'm saying? "If you overcome, I will give you power over the nations." Amekupatia wife. Kama mwenene hapa, amepatia wife. Asa, your wife is a work now. Ukishikilia huyo mmoja. Nata kikuangalia hivi, unasema tu ni sawa. Na mshikilia huyo mmoja. Sitaki mwingine. Unashikilia mmoja. "If you overcome." Can you imagine? Whatever God has given you, if you overcome to hold it, he shall give you power over the nations. There is a reward that is coming for everything that God has given you. But mimi nataka kuwa apostle. No, listen. When God gives you an assignment, no assignment from God is small. Do you know, saizi ukiambiwa na President Ruto, "Come and brush my shoes," Unajua mimi nitatupostia hapo kwa online. He did it, he has done it again. God did it. God's plan. Tunaku inbox, what is happening? I'm brushing the shoes of the president. Kumbe brushing shoes can be something when you are doing it for a great person. Taking photos in church, washing the church, singing in church is not a small thing. You are doing it for God. Na anasema, if you hold it and you keep my works until the end, I will give you power over the nations. Do you understand what I'm saying? So utashangaa your time, some leaders you don't know them. Shangaa, who was this? Siko na muona online. He was a faithful person in a particular village somewhere. In a village somewhere, a faithful pastor with 10 members, praying for them, visiting them, doing soul winning. Church I grow, he's praying, then amekuwa raptured. In this time, atapatiwa power over nations. And you shall know their names. You shall know names of people that you have never heard because of their faithfulness in serving God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are we together? Tuko pamoja kweli? I have so many scriptures, so I'm trying to choose. Which one do I give you? 2 Timothy 2:12. 2 Timothy 2:12. Look at this. This is why we must serve God now. Are we together? Yeah. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 12. Inasema, if we endure, we will also reign with him. There you go. If you endure, you will also reign with him. I'm telling you, there's a reigning that is coming. Wale wenye mnaenda high school mission, hata saa zile umechoka, go. Hata saa zile umebwe, go. Just sema, I am enduring. I'm telling you, if you endure, you shall reign with him. I said you shall reign with him. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you hearing what I'm saying? Luke 19 verse 15. Let me use this one. Luke 19, 15. Am I encouraging somebody to serve God?
Yes.
Whatever you are doing is not small. Watoto wako kila siku unawaombea. Unawasomea Bible story. That thing you are doing shall be rewarded. And so it was when he returned, when Jesus will return. Having received the kingdom, now that Jesus has received what? The kingdom. He then commanded the servants to whom he had given the money to be called to him, that he might know how much everyone has gained by trading. Continue. Verse 16. Then came the first saying, Master, your money has earned 10 shillings. Continue. And he said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. Because you are faithful in a very little, have authority over 10. I wish I was talking to two people here. Kwa sababu umekuwa faithful kunipatia 10 minas. Hata ukiconvert hiyo si pesa mingi sana. Compared to 10 cities. The reward will be too much compared to your service. Ah, you are missing what I'm saying. Aujawahi ona mtu anachora president, amemchora vibaya. President ameenda ushago fulani huko Kadonzweni. Chani enda mbali na Pastor Brenda. President ameenda huko Murang'a. Huko Kisumu. Huko Kadonzweni. Alafu president ameenda kufungua some school there. Then unasikia president there is a boy here that is an artist. Simshaiona watoto. Amechora president. Amemchora vibaya. President Ruto anakaa President Uhuru. Sasa anaenda anampatia. President anatoa 10,000. 20,000. I mean what this person has done. But because he's giving it to the president. Do you know you are washing the church for Jesus? Do you know you call people to come to church for Jesus? Do you know you wake up to pray for the church for Jesus? Tutaangalia kile unampatia hiyo siku. Kevin Misiko come. So yoni angel ameita Kevin. Apeane kazi yake. Kakazi kake si kamingi. Lakini alikuwa nini? Faithful. Anakapeana. Then unasikia 10 cities. The reward and the work. Listen, you shall reign with him. in millennium. I said you shall reign with him. You shall have 5 cities under you. 10 cities under you. Yeah. Wale watu wenye walipita tribulation ndio wako huko hivyo. Wewe ndio president wao. You are the chief there. Do you understand what I'm saying? Are we together? Are you learning something? Continue. The next verse. Next verse. 18. DJ, you shall be rewarded if you do quickly. And the second came saying, Master, your shillings have earned me 5 shillings. Continue. Likewise, he said to him, you also be over 5 cities. Wow. Continue. Then another came saying, Master, here is your shilling, which I kept and put away in a handkerchief. Huyo ni mtu wako kwa hii service. Continue. For I feared you because you are an astute man. You collect what you did not deposit, and you reap what you did not sow. Continue. And he said to him, out of your mouth I will judge you, you wicked servant. You knew that I am an astute man, collecting what I did not deposit and reaping what I did not sow. Continue. Why then did you not put my money in the bank, that at my coming I might have collected with interest? Continue. And he said to those who stood by, take the shilling that is from him and give to him that has 10. Who are these people? But when you only hide their talent, are people that, do you know, only hide your talent. So hata wale watu wenye walikuwa na 5 talents na 10 talents hawakujua ako nayo. Alificha yake. Hawa ni watu wenye ni wa Kristo na hatujui kama ni wa Kristo. Because you know them by their fruits, by what they are doing. Do you know there are so many people that will shock you in heaven? Utaingia binguni ushangae, pia wewe ni Mkristo, akwambia yeye nafunga nimeokoka. But like what? Sijai kuona church. Nimeokoka straight sana kabisa. Yeah, mimi ukamba na kanyuma, sometimes natoka ikiendelea na kuja late. Unajua walk yangu na God ilikuwa personal. Walk yangu na God ilikuwa nini? Ilikuwa personal. Nasema wako hapa, si unajua? Mimi ukam like, you know, like it's more personal, it's more like, you know. Yeah. So you also had a talent, yes, ilikuwa kwa handkerchief. All of us were workers, we were serving him. But yangu ilikuwa kwa handkerchief. What he had will be taken away. So these are people who will begin empty in the millennium. Your brothers on answer na 10 cities. Wao unaanza na not even a shilling. Not a coin. Na ulikuwa raptured. Hauna hata coin. Mtu alikuwa anaosha hapa church akona 1 city. Akona 1 town. And you are raptured with an immortal body. You don't have anything. The only thing you have is an immortal body. So kazi yako tu ni kufly huko shua. Sure. Yeah, utaona huko, utaona kwa millennium. Kuna Wakristo kazi yao ni kufly. Sure, disappearing. Wanatishia wale wenye hawana immortal bodies. But hawana any authority because they were not serving God. Tell your neighbor, serve God. Turn to the other neighbor, tell them, serve God. Now, I want to show you something that God told me this morning. Can I show you? Look at Revelation 4:10. Revelation 4:10. This is very powerful. I want to show you why you must get rewards. It's not for show off. Why you must have cities. It's not for show off. Bible nasema, the 24 elders fall down before him who sits on the throne and worship him, who lives forever and ever, and cast down their crowns before the throne, saying, continue, you are holy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by you were all things created. Bible inasema the 24 elders, they cast down their crowns. Do you know the weight of your worship is in what you have? When a broke person comes and tells you, hey, chairman, when I'm normal, maybe you have like 100 or 1,000 bob. Unaitwa chairman. Na watu broke, si ndio? But when the prince of Saudi Arabia calls you chairman, it means you are something. Ah, you are missing what I'm saying. When a broke person calls you chairman, maybe you just have like 10,000. But when the president akikumita na inama anasema chairman, it means you are a very great person. So the 24 elders, their worship is not beautiful because of they are elders. It is not because of their eldership. It's because they have crowns. What are crowns? Rewards. We shall get crowns as rewards. Kama umeweka ukue the leader of 10 cities, there will be a crown in itakuwa inaonesha you are a leader of 10 cities. Ah, you're missing what I'm saying. So, sitaki kupata crowns ndio niringe. I want to get crowns so that I can remove them. The reason why I want to have 10 cities is to increase the quality of my worship in eternity. Mungu anasema, somebody with 10 cities is bowing down to me. Somebody with 100 cities is bowing down to me. Ah, you're missing what I'm saying. This is what I am serving God to get crowns to take them off. I am serving God today so that I get crowns so that I can take them off. Otherwise, what will be the benefit of being the leader of 10 cities? Na your neighbor ana cities na ana fly. Sure, hana njaa, akona nyumba. What is the benefit of being the leader of 10 cities? It is that crown. It is the quality of your crown. Because we shall worship him in eternity. So what crown will you be putting off? Ni crown gani utakuwa unatoa in eternity? What will be the quality of your crown? Is a village elder worshiping Jesus in a millennium. Village elder crown. Umepatiwa Dandora Phase 3. You are crown of Dandora Phase 3. Somebody akona the crown of Africa. Pia yeye anaingia Jerusalem. Na anaitoa. Anaambia Jesus, you are my God. Do you know how Jesus will feel when that kind of a person is worshiping him? We are fighting with faithfulness to get crowns so that we have something to remove every time we go before his throne. Somebody say, oh Lord, help me to serve you. Help me to be faithful in the name of Jesus. So I've told you, there are so many things that we can share about the millennium. But nilikuwa naangalia all the things that we can talk about. From Satan being released to deceive people. And you know he will deceive people. And Bible inasema they'll be like the sand of the sea. So many people will follow him. And after they follow Satan, kwa sababu watasema, we don't like Jesus. Kwa ni ndio leader peke yake huko Jerusalem. Shetani awaambia watu, don't you want democracy where you can be voting for your leaders? The same thing that entered the Israelites when God wanted to be their king. Mnanielewa? When God wanted to be their king, inaitwa theocracy. When God is king, something entered them, ikawaambia, we want democracy. We want to choose our leader. So that same temptation will come back again when Jesus is seated on the throne. And some nations will begin to rise against Israel, coming to dethrone Jesus. Na Bible inasema when they are gathered, like the sand of the sea, fire will come from heaven and devour them. Watachomwa wote na moto. And that will be the end. After that, kutakuwa na wote inaitwa the great white throne judgment. This is the judgment of sinners. And they will be cast into the lake of fire later. Upon your death, itachukuliwa. Death is a spirit. And Hades will be taken. And they'll be thrown into the lake of fire. From that time, Mungu atachukua hii dunia, ayaribu, and kutakuwa na a new heaven and a new earth. And on that new earth, something else will come upon it. Inaitwa the new Jerusalem. John anasema, I saw a city imemetameta like the bride for her groom. Na hiyo city itakuja ingie Jerusalem. Itakuja on the earth. It is the new Jerusalem. And that is where the Father will be. That is where the Son will be. That is where the 12 apostles, their names zitakuwa zimeandikwa kwa the foundation of the city. The city will have around 1600 or something miles in length, height and width. It will be a square city, fortified with open gates that we can be walking in anytime we want. Do you understand what I'm saying? Are you looking forward for that day? You see, it is only iko tu hapa. If the rapture happens now, that day is not very far. It is just here. So nilikuwa naangalia, I have all these things to tell you that people will be deceived by Satan. They don't have hunger, they don't have chaos, their marriages are working, they don't lack money, but they will still be deceived by Satan to reject Jesus. Then you can understand, wow, the heart of man is so wicked. We say that, no, you don't understand. People are sinning because of poverty. It is not poverty. It is because the heart of man is deceitful. There are people who don't have money and are not stealing. There are girls who don't have money and are not prostitutes. Don't tell me you are a prostitute because you don't have money. Don't tell me you are stealing because you don't have money. You are stealing because you have a wicked heart. The heart of man is deceitful. In the millennium, they shall not be lacking anything. Kama ni pesa itakuwa. Kama ni everything itakuwa. But they will still reject him. There is wickedness in the heart of man. And only Jesus can take away that wickedness. So I was looking at all these things. What do I teach you about the millennium? And I count one of the greatest lessons I can tell you. As believers, serve God. Serve God faithfully. Serve God. I was looking at the millennium, the new heaven, the new earth. Nikasema, what should be the one lesson that we should teach each other if we are born again? Whatever you have been told to do, do it faithfully. I said, do it faithfully. It will be the percentage of your faithfulness that will guarantee rewards. Do you understand what I'm saying? Are you sure you're understanding what I'm saying? Are you sure you're understanding what I'm saying? I want us to pray. I will do some podcasts. These are the end times. And I will cover what we have not covered. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Serve God. Amua, Saturday ndio watu wenda out queen souls. Siko job Saturday. Let me join them. But sijui queen souls come. Every Saturday we are here. Katikati ya wiki watu wanaenda shule mission. Let me confirm which day do they go. I want to participate. Kuna watu wa wanaosha hii church. Let me be part of the people that wash the church. Yeah. Do something for God and do it faithfully. See leo huko, kesho huko, siku ingine anilisahau. Do it faithfully. You shall be rewarded. Whatever you lift up your hands as you are seated down. We are praying one prayer. Lord, have mercy on me for my unfaithfulness in serving you. Have mercy on me for my unfaithfulness. Inconsistency. Inconsistency in serving. Excuses in serving God. Mediocre serving God. Lord, I want you to come quickly. I want you to come. But I still want to serve you before you come. I still need time to show you that I can serve you. I still need a few more weeks, a few more months, maybe a few more years, if you will, for me to serve you faithfully. Lord, I still want you to come. I want you to come. But I'm asking for a few more weeks, a few more months, a few more years to at least be faithful in serving you. Makato shatala bakataya. Lord, if there is any agenda against my life, any agenda of early death, premature death, please, Lord, let that agenda be terminated. I want time. I want time. I want time. I need time to serve you. I need time. Don't allow me to die young. You have a servant in me. If there's any agenda against my life, please, Lord, let that agenda be terminated. I need time to serve you. I need time to be faithful. Talk to him. From today, I enter a new level of faithfulness. I will not wait for people. I will not wait for the department. I will not wait for the team. No, this thing is personal. This thing is, I understand that it is personal. Wherever you are, stand up on your feet. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Lift them high. I'm giving you one more minute. This prayer, if you follow up on this prayer, it will change your life. Tell him, Lord, guide me as I serve you. Yeah, nisifanye kitu hujaniambia nifanye. Begin to show me what I must do. Begin to show me what I must do. Talk to him. Show me what I must do. It's not about the pastor. It's not about the department. It is not about the denomination. This thing is personal. Lord, show me what I must do. Show me where I must go. To the streets, hospitals, teaching them the word. In Jesus' name. Let me tell you something. We were talking leo, ama ni jana. Ngona sema, it is very important for people to know which prophetic time they live in. Ni vizuri ujue, uko kwa which prophetic time. In the church age, after Jesus left, until the rapture, each time, the main assignment is win souls, make disciples. Win souls, make disciples. It is the main assignment. So, kuna watu wanasema, I serve God by taking people to school, paying school fees. It is good. And let me tell you something. God will pay you. God will reward you for paying people school fees, giving people clothes, giving people food. God will reward you. But I'm saying, the main assignment of your prophetic time, make sure as you take the clothes, na wamekaa chini wachukue nguo, you have someone to tell them about Jesus. Make sure ukipeleka chakula, as they sit down, make sure there is somebody to tell them you need to give your lives to Jesus. Combine your passion with your assignment, the assignment of this prophetic time. If you're an artist, you sing, you draw, you act. Find a way of combining what you do with your assignment for this prophetic hour. If you're a business person, lipia watu fare for soul winning. Sema nashindwa kuja Saturday. But every Saturday, I'll be sending 100 bob. 200 bob. Ndio watu wanaenda nje wapate fare. I want to give fare for soul winners. I want to buy water for soul winners. Yeah. I want to combine what God is doing through you with the main assignment for the season. Yeah. We are planting churches because of what? Soul winning and making disciples. We are not opening a church that is not winning souls. We don't want a church that is not making disciples. Yeah. What is the point? The main assignment for the season is win souls, make disciples. Lift up your hands. I want us to pray this prayer. Say, oh Lord, as I pray, help me to connect to the main assignment for this prophetic season. In the name of Jesus. Begin to pray that prayer. Begin to pray that prayer. Begin to pray that prayer. Help me, Lord, to connect to the main assignment for this prophetic season. My talents, my gifts, I connect them to the main assignment. The main assignment. The main assignment. I connect my talent, my business, my career. I connect it to this prophetic season.